OmniFocus 4.7 introduced some welcome enhancements to the repeat feature in OmniFocus. The repeat feature was already very useful, but this update takes it to a new level. And I'm going to highlight one of the features, one that I find very useful, and something that makes OmniFocus even more convenient to use. So let's say my next-door neighbor Jean is going on vacation, and he asks that I feed his cat. I want to make sure that the repeat starts the day that he leaves and ends the day that he gets back. And in previous versions of OmniFocus, you could only have things that repeat off into the future indefinitely, and you'd have to manually drop or delete the item once you no longer need the repeat. But OmniFocus 4 allows you to specify either an end date or a number of repetitions. Let's look at how this works. We'll look at it on the Mac, but it's essentially the same on other platforms as well. So here's the action to feed Jean's cat. I'm going to put that in my friends and family list. I'm going to tag it with home because Jean lives right next door. And let's say Jean is leaving on September 1st. And he's going to be back on the 8th of September. So I want this action to become available on September 1st. And I want it to repeat every day until September 8th. So I'm going to click on repeat. I'm clicking on it in the outline. I've enabled this field in the outline. You could also get to this feature in the inspector as well. And if you've used previous versions of OmniFocus, you'll notice that the Omni group have made some nice changes to the layout of the repeat configuration. So in this case, I want it to repeat every day. We'll have it based on the defer date. So if I mark it complete on September 1st, it'll become available again on September 2nd. And the key feature I want to highlight here is this new end field. So I can go to end and I can have it end on a specific date, which is what we're going to do. Or I could say I want it to end after a certain number of repetitions. So I'll go ahead and choose on date, and I'm going to set the date to September 8th. And then I can hide these configuration options. And if you look over in the inspector, you'll see it says repeat every one day based on the defer date, and the repeat ends on September 8th. So once September 8th comes along, it won't repeat any further. There's no need to make any manual changes. And if you're not seeing these fields in the outline or the inspector, you can go into the settings. Right now I'm in the inspector and you'll see the repeat field is selected. You can move this up in the inspector if you like. I'll just leave it in the current position. And similarly, over in the outline, you can set it to show up as a display or editing field in the fluid defaults, or as a column in the column layout. I'll go into the fluid defaults, and you'll see that repeat is enabled there as well. I'll just close down the settings. So that's just a taste of what's possible using the enhanced repeat functionality that was introduced in OmniFocus 4.7. I'll be covering other use cases and a more detailed look at repeats in future content on Learn OmniFocus. This is Tim Stringer from Learn OmniFocus. Thanks for watching.